Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to go through how to update properties in HubSpot, update fields, update what you can see here using workflows. So in particular, it's when you create a new property and you want to transfer all the information over from the old property to the new property using workflows to do that. I recently did another video about country and about adding the country dropdown. So you can see here that we've got this country dropdown. HubSpot comes with a country region option, and usually it is text only. So you can see here, it might look something like this. You've got your country and it might be typed out like that, and you want to make it a dropdown instead. So you or your customers, your clients can also update by selecting from a dropdown like this. So we want to do the same. We want to basically take all this information that we've got from here and put it in the new property that we've created. Check out that other video if you want to see how to do the create the new property. I go into a bit more detail there. But for this video, we're just going to do a workflow. And we're going to create a couple of workflows to basically transfer this information over to the country column instead. And I'll do a separate video on how to export and import as well, which I think might be the fastest way to do this particular case. But we'll use this as an opportunity to look at workflows as well. So workflows may depend on your level of your subscription. So I think HubSpot Enterprise level, I think have the ability to do this workflows. I'm not sure about the starter, the standard sort of level, or the free level. So it'll depend on the agreement you've got. So let's go ahead and look at workflows. So basically what we're aiming to do here is we've got all these blank properties here, and we want to take this Australia here and place it here. It's a little bit tricky because this is text and this is dropdown. So if this was text as well, which, you know, would defeat the purpose of this particular process, but we would easily be able to just say copy, 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 copy with workflows. But because it's a dropdown, it may be a little bit more challenging. So let's create a workflow now from scratch, and we will see why it's going to be challenging. So we start the workflow. Usually I like to start by naming the workflow. So we're just going to make this one, I'm just going to say admin, because it's kind of internal, and then copy country old to country dropdown property. So I try and be descriptive if I can. It's not perfect, but at least I kind of know what I'm looking at here, rather than just having, you know, workflow one, workflow two, workflow three, and losing track very easily. And now we decide what our enrollment trigger is going to be. So HubSpot have added this a couple of other options for enrollment triggers. We are going to stick with the filter criteria is met one, but there are, in another video, I'll go through event-based workflow triggers. So let's start with this one here, when the criteria is met. And we're going to add the filter. We're going to add the contact. We're talking about contact properties today. So we're going to add the contact property filter. And we're going to say when the country region old is known. This, that means we know there's some data, something in that property. And we're going to also say when the contact property country, which is the new one we've created, is unknown, so we don't, you know, copy any that are already done. Don't have to do it like this, but this is the way I like to sort of set it up. So we save that. So one's known, one's, and the new one is unknown. This is going to enroll a contact here. And then we want to set, basically, normally we would say we would have a property. So let's do a quick search for property. So we would copy the property value over. But let's try that now. We'll find we probably can't do that because they're different styles of properties. You know, one's a single text and one is a dropdown. But let's have a look anyway. So we've got country, and we can see we can't select it. We've got to click here. So we're going to property or copy to, sorry, property to copy from. So we're going to copy from the old country, and then we're going to copy it to the new country. And we can't do it because it is not editable. So we will have to do it another way. And the other way we're going to do it is by setting. Instead, we're going to set the property value. So we're going to do it with a, it's a little bit more complicated, but we're going to add a step to split the contact, to split the property into a few different scenarios because we've got five countries. So let's start with the, let's have a look, where are we? Branch. So we've got a few options for branch. We can base it on a single property value, based on matching filter criteria, based on single action outcome. So we're going to say matching filter criteria. Actually, let's try single property value and property branch. And we select refine country old. And we say next. And we say Australia. We say New Zealand. Let's have a look at our options here. We've got Australia, we've got New Zealand, Singapore, UK, and US. So let's save some time here. I'll just change this to 100. Grab New Zealand. Paste that here. Yep. Oh, I did that already. We've got Singapore. Paste that. UK. And US. Okay, and we'll leave this branch 6 unmet as blank. It's okay, we don't need that. Here are the countries that we want to transfer over. And the reason we're doing this is because we need to actually set HubSpot to go for each one and make a change. We can't simply copy-paste over because these are drop-downs. And so the text, HubSpot and the system won't necessarily know from a text-based property which drop-down they should select. Even though it's very easy for a human to sort of see that Australia is Australia, it's not possible for a dropdown to automatically relate to a text-based property. So instead, we kind of help it along a little bit. So we're basically, just to recap, we've got the enrollment trigger. We say that the country region is known. That's the old data that we've got. And we're going to update the new data when the country region is unknown, when the country is unknown. We have the branch step. So the contact comes to this step. We look at the detail that they have in this property, country region old, and then we funnel them based on the property results through one of these options here. So let's start with Australia. We're going to update a property here. We're going to set a property value. And now we should be able to find our country property. Here it is with drop down. And we select Australia like so and save. We do the same for New Zealand. So we say property. Let's see if we can do this faster way. Okay, I'm going to quickly clone these, which will make it slightly faster. Clone this action and place, save, clone, place, save, clone, place, save. Now we quickly add. The appropriate drop-down should be Singapore, save, New Zealand, save, UK. Oops, what am I doing? UK, save, and Australia, United States. Okay, United States, and save. So now we have all our options. We just double check everything looks right. Zoom out a little bit here. There we go. Oops. And then this would normally be off. I had it on before. And we can review and turn on. We enroll all the contacts. It'll say there's like 100 or so. And we turn that on. And then it's going to go through an update. Here we've got our view from before the contacts view. So in this view, we've got our new country property with the dropdown that we were talking about. And we have, let me go back and add that in. We've got the country old property here. Let's drag that up. Put that after the new country property. Apply that. Just save this view. So now we can compare. Country old. So you can see we're missing New Zealand. Let's see what's happening here in the workflow. I'll just refresh. I might have moved a bit too quickly for this. Let's see. We go to details. And we're still, I know what's happened. Because I had the workflow on while I was editing, let me just turn that off. We're going to set for re-enrollment. So because I might have, some of these contacts might have been enrolled before I'd set up the steps here, because I had the workflow turned on already, which I should have turned it off before. So those contacts might have already gone through and not been updated because they didn't have a classification that they should go through. So I'm going to go in here into the trigger step, and just here I click on re-enrollment, and I've turned on the re-enrollment option. And so basically those contacts can go back through this workflow. And then let's click review and publish. And we'll say yes, enroll everyone. So this is another important step. You can choose in the workflow, you can choose whether you want contacts to be re-enrolled or be enrolled at the start when you turn on the workflow, or just later on when a change happens in the future. So if you're turning it on and enrolling everyone at that time, basically saying everyone that's in the HubSpot database that should be triggered here based on the trigger filter properties here, then those contacts will be enrolled immediately. So in this case, 82 would be enrolled immediately. But otherwise, if you say no, then it'll just be contacts that have that, you know, get added from now on in the future to your database. So let's turn this on with 82. And we can track under details here, we can see what steps, who's gone through which steps, who's been enrolled, what are the actions that they've taken, that the system's taken. We can see here. And then enrollment history, so who's completed the workflow. Let's have a look here if any further ones have been updated. Yeah, I think we just saw that New Zealand popped up. So we've got New Zealand, Singapore, UK. It looks like everyone's... Yes, that's great. So that's worked now. And we've used this workflow to update. So you can go back to and have a look at my other video. I've got a video about doing this with bulk updates where you select, you know, all the contacts you want and you click edit like this. And there'll be another video as well about import-export. So you can compare and see which method is your preferred method for updating properties when they're the same but slightly different setup. And you want to move the properties between, you know, to an older property and a new property. You want to move the data. This option here that we've just gone through is workflow option. There's the option to do it with the bulk edit option here, and then there's an option to do it with the import and export. So I'll go through and I'll show you the import export one in another video, and then you can decide what works for you. So I hope that's been useful, and please share your questions and thoughts, and let me know any other videos, anything else which would be good to go through in the future for HubSpot or other tutorials relating to this area. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.